All right, so I am well aware of the fact that whenever we talk about COVID-19 on this channel, it's almost always negative. And there's a lot of bad news. It's a public health crisis, a global pandemic. Of course, there's not going to be that many rosy stories. Having said that, though, this time, in this video, we're going to break the cycle because we actually have some genuinely encouraging news. So first of all, COVID-19 cases in the United States are in fact down, and they're down substantially. So we've seen a 24% decline in new cases over the last 2 weeks, which signals an end to the Delta variant surge, which is great news. Now, second of all, we have multiple studies now confirming just how effective the COVID-19 vaccines are, and they are very, very effective. So in early July, researchers at Yale University and the Commonwealth Fund estimated that the COVID-19 vaccines have saved 279,000 lives because of these vaccines. Incredible. And a report from the Department of Health and Human Services found that nearly 40,000 elderly lives were spared between January and May because of the COVID-19 vaccines, and they also prevented hundreds of thousands of new infections. Now, as Kenny Stenzel of Common Dreams explains, according to the study on the relationship between county-level inoculation rates and COVID-19 outcomes among Medicare beneficiaries, which was conducted by researchers at the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, vaccines helped ward off 265,000 infections, 107,000 hospitalizations, and 39,000 deaths during the first 5 months of 2021. That is absolutely incredible. Hundreds of thousands of lives saved because of the COVID-19 vaccines, and 40,000 elderly lives saved during January and May. That is truly remarkable. The vaccines work, and they're not just beneficial for you as an individual, but they're great for society as well. In fact, they're really good for society because new research by British researchers at the University of Oxford found that they also reduce transmission. If you've been fully vaccinated, you are less likely to spread COVID-19 to your peers. Now, Dr. Akshay Sahel gives us the breakdown about this new data in an NBC News article and explains people who are vaccinated against COVID-19 are less likely to spread the virus even if they become infected, a new study finds, adding to a growing body of evidence that vaccines can reduce transmission of the Delta variant. British scientists at the University of Oxford examined national records of 150,000 contacts that were traced from roughly 100,000 initial cases. The samples included people who were fully or partially vaccinated with either the Pfizer, BioNTech, or AstraZeneca vaccines, as well as people who were unvaccinated. The researchers then looked at how the vaccines affected the spread of the virus if a person had a breakthrough infection with either the Alpha variant or the highly contagious Delta variant. Both vaccines reduced transmission, although they were more effective against the Alpha variant compared to the Delta variant. When infected with the Delta variant, a given contact was 65% less likely to test positive if the person from whom the exposure occurred was fully vaccinated with two doses of the Pfizer vaccine. With AstraZeneca, a given contact was 36% less likely to test positive if the person from whom the exposure occurred was fully vaccinated. The risk of transmission from a breakthrough infection was much higher if someone had received just one dose of either vaccine. So this is really, really encouraging. It's great to hear. It's another reason to take the vaccine. If you don't care about yourself, then you should take the vaccine if you care about other people. Now, this study has not been peer-reviewed as of yet, but researchers are confident that this is actually a very high-quality study. In fact, Dr. Aaron Richerman of the University of Pennsylvania says this about the study. It's the highest quality study we have so far on the question of infectiousness of vaccinated people and infected with Delta. So this is really, really encouraging news. The vaccines are saving hundreds of thousands of lives, and we're really privileged to have them not just be free, but widely available, especially considering there are people in developing countries that still haven't even been able to get their first dose. So the fact that we have this here, this truly speaks to the innovations and the amazingness of modern medicine, thanks to government funding as well, but it's important. So the reason why I'm talking about this is because if you're one of the few people who watch this show that aren't vaccinated and you come here just to troll for whatever reason, I mean, the data speaks for itself. This is actual science, unlike the memes that you're sharing on Facebook by your racist aunts and uncles. This is data. This is evidence. So at this point, with everything that we know, with all of the data that we have available, anyone who's discouraging you from taking the vaccines, any other YouTuber whose video catalog looks like this, they are not to be taken seriously. In fact, with the evidence that we have confirming how effective these vaccines are, this kind of misinformation at this point is bound to get someone killed. But I mean, when you have a conspiratorial right-wing audience to appease, you have to make some sacrifices. And if you gamble with people's lives, I guess some people are willing to pay that price. But for me, no, I'm not willing to pay that price. I want you to protect yourself and others. I want you to get vaccinated. I don't care who you are. If you're a right-winger, if you're apolitical, if you hate me, if you hate the Humanist Report, I don't believe you should die when we have a cure. We have a vaccine that isn't just highly effective, as this research shows, but it's also incredibly safe. Millions of people in this country have taken it. Billions of people around the globe have taken it. It's fine. I took it. I'm fine. I haven't spontaneously combusted. But, you know, some people have an agenda, like Jimmy Dore. Some people are incredibly irresponsible with their platform, and they don't care if people die. In fact, I don't know what Jimmy Dore believes, but he might believe that he's the one who has the truth. But objectively speaking, he doesn't. These studies show that the vaccines are incredibly effective, and anyone who's telling you to not get them isn't looking out for your best interests. They don't care about you. They care about views and clicks. But this is a public health crisis, and for those of you who are tired of all this talk of lockdowns and masks, the quicker we all get the COVID-19 vaccine, the faster we all go back to normal, which I desperately want at this point. I'm sick of the pandemic, and if you're as tired of this nonsense as I am, get the fucking vaccine so we're not in this perpetual state of plague forever. Now, thankfully, again, cases are down, so I don't want to turn this into a negative video, so I apologize for digressing, but we've got to get the vaccine. It's available, it's safe, and the best part about it is it fucking works really well.